Cephanyr is a loyal spirit guardian that has been trained to detect the traces of trapped souls. Hello there. In this video, we're going to show you how to paint the skin of Cephanyr from Cyreni's razors. The paints we'll be using are on the screen now. We also have a list of the additional equipment we've used, but you can use whatever brushes you feel most comfortable with. If you're new to painting or want to brush up on your skills, you can check out the Citadel Color Painting Essentials videos to learn all about our paints and painting techniques. We've undercoated our model with gray sear to give us that nice light base to work from. Right, let's get painting. For our first paint, we'll be using Flayed One Flesh that has been thinned out with Lamium Medium. We're using a 3-to-1 mix of Lamium Medium to Flayed One Flesh, and we'll be applying it all over Cephanyr with a medium shade brush. Don't worry about being neat here, just get your first layer on. Make sure to keep the paint moving and try to avoid painting the same area repeatedly, as this will build up unwanted texture. Allow your first layer to completely dry before coming back to do another layer. If we look at the box art, we can see that Cephanyr's skin is a little darker around the head, so we'll be focusing our second layer there. With that complete, we've got our nice pale skin tone established. We're now going to use Kislev Flesh, mixed with a 3-to-1 ratio with Lamium Medium, and apply it all over the areas where we want to be slightly darker. We're using a medium layer brush here for a little more control. We've thinned this out with Lamium Medium as well, because it will help to create the transition in colors that we can see on the box art. We'll be applying this over the eyebrows, top of the head, and where all the tentacles meet the body. You'll notice that the paint will tint the raised areas as well as sit in the recesses. With that step complete, the skin is starting to take shape. Okay, we need to add a bit more depth of color now, and for this we'll be using Bugman's Glow in two ways. We'll be using a medium layer brush for this step as well. Firstly, we're going to use Bugman's Glow thinned with a little water and applied over the eyebrows, top of the head, and the two hardened areas of the large tentacles. Then, we'll mix Lamium Medium with our Bugman's Glow to a 3-to-1 ratio and apply it over the Whirlpool symbol on the forehead and pick out where the tentacles meet the body. When doing this, make sure to start a little higher up than the previous Kislev Flesh layer. This will help with the transition effect we want. We're also going to pick out the two smaller tentacles under the body. When we're done with that, we're then going to recess shade all the tentacles to give them some more definition. With that complete, there are just two more steps to go. Our next paint will be Gull Vorback Red, thinned with a little water. We're going to use a medium layer brush to paint the very highest area of the head. Just look at the box art for reference if you need to, as well as picking out the hardened areas of the tentacles and the suckers on the back of the tentacles. When picking out the hardened areas of the tentacles, leave a Bugman's Glow layer showing along the base edges as a barrier between the underside of the tentacles and the Gull Vorback layer. Okay, our skin is almost complete. We just need to add some highlights. For our last stage, we're going to use Pallid Witch Flesh, mixed with a little water to pick out any edges we can find, as well as gently glaze over the surface of the tentacles. We're using a medium layer brush here and mixing a lot of water with our Pallid Witch Flesh to get it to a glaze consistency. That means it will be thinner than a shade consistency. Looking at the box art, we can see that the tentacles are very pale towards the tips. So we're glazing over the surface of them to achieve this effect. Glazing works well here, as it won't give a hard line between the previous colors that we've used and where we're placing Pallid Witch Flesh. With the pale tone of the tentacles established, we're now going to do a more traditional edge highlight to pick out all the edges and features that we can see. We're using Pallid Witch Flesh for the edge highlight too, but we need it to be a slightly thicker consistency. So just mix it with only a little water. With that step done, our skin is complete. And there we go. Cephanyr's skin looks awesome. We've just picked out the eyes with Bad Moon Yellow as a finisher. All that's left for you to do is paint the base in whatever colors match the rest of your collection. For more tutorials, tips, and tricks, check out our videos on the Warhammer YouTube channel, or you can head to your local Warhammer store where our amazing staff will be more than happy to help. Well, we hope you've enjoyed this video and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.